Hello, many of you have asked us about nil geometry. In this video, we will try to explain how this geometry works. Let us recall that there are some shapes that are impossible in the Euclidean geometry. However, they are possible in the non-Euclidean geometries. For example, right-angled pentagons are possible in hyperbolic geometry. If you haven't seen such exotic shapes yet, we recommend our other videos. See the link in the description. However, today we will deal with a different kind of impossibility. In 1959, Lionel Penrose and Roger Penrose have constructed an impossible figure called the Penrose staircase. At the first glance, the staircase looks like a projection of a valid Euclidean construction. But a closer examination reveals that it is not spatially possible. It seems we could not construct a three-dimensional model of such a staircase. Or could we? No, this was just a perspective trick. But why are we talking about those impossible figures? Do they have some relation to nil? Let's find out. Nil is a three-dimensional geometry. Every point has three coordinates. We can move in six directions, which we will call north, east, south, west, up, and down. In the Euclidean geometry, moving in one of these directions by one unit simply changes the matching coordinate by one. In nil, it is a bit more complex. Moving north, east, south, or west also changes our z coordinate. The formulas look strange at the first glance, but the idea is actually simple. The change in the z coordinate is the area of a triangle as shown in the picture. The change is positive if we go counterclockwise and negative if we go clockwise. Let us imagine a tour in the Euclidean geometry using directions north, east, south, and west such that we return to the starting point. It would be a kind of loop. If we recreated the same steps in nil geometry, we would end up directly above or below the starting point with the difference in the z coordinate proportional to the area of the loop. So let's use this behavior to recreate the Penrose staircase. First, let's try to use this behavior in the Euclidean geometry. We build every step lower, and of course, after one loop, we end up lower than we started, so the staircase does not cycle. Now, let's use the magic of nil to recompensate the lost height. We can create the staircase that we can descend forever. This animation may look a bit like cheating, but this is because we are showing a Euclidean model of nil. It is not what the inhabitants of such strange worlds would see. So let's become those inhabitants. Here are our stairs in the first-person perspective from the inside. You might notice an unexpected effect that the world seems to spin. Why does this happen? According to Fermat's principle, the path taken by a light ray is always the shortest one. To understand how light works in nil, let's think a bit about moving from 0, 0 and 0 to 0, 0 and 25. First, there is an obvious path of length 25. But can we do it better? Yes, we can. Here is a square of edge length 5. Since such a square has an area of 25 and a perimeter of 20, it takes us to 0, 0 and 25 in just 20 steps. We can do even better. Queen Dido has already known that among shapes with a given area, the circle has the shortest perimeter. Using a circle with an area of 25 will give us a shorter path that will lead us quicker to our destination. But That is just the silver medal. For the gold medal, we need to combine the silver and the green puffs. We make the circle slightly smaller and we satisfy the difference by moving slightly upwards. The length of such a puff can be computed using the Pythagorean theorem and minimized by differentiation. There is the optimal radius which yields the best puff. In Nil, the light ray puffs, called geodesics, are like the ones we have just constructed. They are helices. The steeper the helix, the smaller its radius. The view appears to spin because of this curved shape. If you are curious what other impossible figures work in Nil, see the description for our other videos. And as the last treat, here is a landscape in Nil. The unicycle here is using the magic of Nil to go faster and faster. Look how the landscape appears to shift as we move. Thanks for watching and have a great rest of your day.